Yes.
And those freshman, sophomore, junior, senior, and graduate years, as well as academic affairs, student success and engagement, and all the affiliated departments. We appreciate our professors, advisors, and university administrators. And we appreciate the experience of everyone who has aboard and told us over the past few years, encouraging us to persist forth this morning. We thank you all, most mind, for the pressing, the saving, the moving, the making, the reading, the breaking, the forming, and the shaping that this excursion has used to fashion us into who we are on this day, graduates of Virginia State University. Remember for the rest of our lives, shower down your spirit on us and sprinkle these graduates with your grace to follow in the rest of their lives. In the name of all that is holy, sacred, and true, we express our exhilaration and jubilance, and may everybody have to say, Amen. Please remain standing if you are able for the posting of the covers by the Virginia State University Reserve Officer Supreme Court and our national.
Thank you.
free platform testing on students, public officials, members of the Tuesday University faculty, staff, administration, alumni, faculty, and persons faculty members. And of course, the 2017 graduate class of Virginia State University. I'm pleased to greet you this morning as the 14th president of Virginia State University, and I am honored to serve as America's first fully state-supported four-year institution of higher learning from Virginia, Virginia's Opportunity University, Virginia State University. We've got so much to be proud of today. 2017 is a year for the Redwoods. In 2017, we increased our freshman enrollment over 30%. In 2017, we had 14 student athletes who were recognized as Arthur Ashe Junior Scout Awards. And in 2017, on this day, May 13th, this is our first time having spring commencement here in our very own multi-purpose center. And of course, we are graduating one of the most exciting and accomplished classes in recent Virginia State University memory. To our graduates, we hope that after today, you look back fondly upon your years on the hill and recognize it as a transformative experience that began shaping you into who you will be and what you are moving forward from today. Please allow me to take a moment of your time to recognize some of our special guests. I would like to ask that all special guests stand to be recognized. First, I would like to honor my wife, the First Lady of the Virginia State University, Dr. Octavia Collins. I would also like to acknowledge the members of the Board of Visitors who are here today standing behind me. I would like to recognize any state, local, or federal elected officials who are here today enjoying the ceremony. If there are any members of the clergy here, please would you stand to be recognized? If there are any members of the armed services or veterans, would you please take the time to stand? Celebrate today. And for that, the BMG class of 2017. That not only you chose, that you chose to attend Virginia State University, but that you stuck with your choice for 4 years, 5 years, or six years, maybe even longer. But the point is not how long it took you to get here. The point is that if we were in church this month, I'd tell you to look to your people, give them a high five, and tell them you made it. I say that dedication will position you for opportunities that otherwise would not be possible. The degree you receive today is not only a representation of your dedication. It is a culmination of your perseverance combined with the prayers and support of thousands of people who are surrounding you today. It is no doubt that you acknowledge that there is a support system in place in your life that helped lead you through these transitional years. Whether it was a parent or a grandparent, an aunt and uncle, a teacher, a friend, a faculty, or staff member, you were blessed to have graduates. I would like you to stay and give everyone here a round of applause for supporting you through your life.
Made it. I admire your perseverance, hard work, and dedication. These traits will serve you well going forward. As the years pass, you'll gain a deeper appreciation for your time on the Hill, as I have. The bonds and memories you have forged with your fellow Trojans and your school will grow over time. But this day will always stand out, as it should. You, your families, and classmates should be very proud of your accomplishments. I wish each of you the best of luck and Godspeed in all you endeavor to achieve. Hail State, Hail State, Hail, Hail, Hail. We will always be both sons and daughters of orange and blue. Go Classes 2017. Congratulations.
Senior class president for 2016-2017.
Greetings from Virginia State University class of 2017. Today is a day of pride, of achievement, and of joy, not only for us, the graduates, but also for our families who assisted us on this journey. So we want to thank our mothers, our fathers, our siblings, and our friends for providing the encouragement and support needed to keep us on track. And let us not forget our BSU families, the organizations that brought us lasting memories and strong bonds, as well as the administration, faculty, staff, and board of visitors for providing us with an incubator success. Most importantly, thank you, Virginia State University, May 2017 graduates. Thank you for allowing me the humbling honor of representing me, and thank you for upholding the image and honor of this university. And as we continue on our next phase in life, I know that we will bring great honor to retire BSU alumni. Remember that this is not goodbye. This is see you later. See you in the land of success as we depart from the land of children. Thank you.
spring commencement speaker, Mr. Jeff Johnson. Mr. Johnson is an award-winning journalist and motivational speaker. Mr. Johnson is a teller of stories, developer of methods, and architect of social solutions. He's as comfortable in front of the camera as he is behind the scenes developing strategy and messages for his life. He is currently the managing principal of the Baltimore-based strategy firm, JIJ Communications, where he provides strategic insight and messaging consulting to clients in the private, public, and entertainment sector. His clients include Google, the City of Cleveland, and the SuperCAP priorities of the USA. He also provides regular content on the nationally syndicated Ricky Smiley Morning Show. Mr. Johnson formerly served as the National Director of the Youth and College of the NAACP and has an appointment by Russell Simpson as the Vice President of the Hip Hop Summit Action Network. In 2014, he worked with Steve Harvey on his New York Times bestseller, "Act Like a Success, Think Like a Success." Mr. Johnson is also the author of "Everything I'm Not Made, Made Me Everything I Am." He and his wife, Catherine, are proud parents for four. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, help me welcome to the podium, Mr. Jeff Johnson.
Thank you, Mr. President. To the chair of the board, the members of the board of directors, and the board of visitors, to all those that are on the dais, to the faculty and staff, to the illustrious 50 years sufferings of their graduation, to all family, friends, all in protocol and all out of protocol, and of course, the Big State University class of 2017. I would be remiss if I could take a point of personal privilege to recognize my wife, and I would not ask her to stand, but she is rocking. 7-week-old Baldwin John Wayne. Lucky baby. And I think that it's important at this moment, and this is for everybody in this building, because there are a couple of people in this building that remember how difficult it was to get money together for freshman year. There's a couple of people who remember how difficult it was finishing that sophomore year trying to work and go to class at the same time. There's a few people in here who remember trying to navigate the death of a family member or a friend in junior year, and there are a couple of people that were like, I don't know how in the hell I'm going to get through this senior year, and so some people, but not all of you, just need a praise break before we keep going. Black and brown faces on television and movies in ways that aren't just entertaining but are comforting. But I don't think any of those pieces of comfort have been more surprising than Jordan Peele's unbelievable $206 million record making Get Out. But it's fucking amazing when you have 99% on Rotten Tomatoes. I mean, it just don't happen. It doesn't happen. It almost everybody can watch this except it. But if entertainment is involved as much money as it made, there is a lesson for the class of 2017 in the annals of the story. The story by a young man named Chris, who happened to be dating a white girl. That's not really important. He finds himself in the midst of a weekend at her parents' house. And I think it's important for the class of 2017 as you prepare to the end, and I'm going to ask you, right? I know the camp's going to be on you. Ignore the temptation to perform during my speech. I promise you I'm going to keep you all. I just need your attention. I just saw it on things and it was beautiful. I love it. Just give me 10 minutes. So we see Chris going to spend the weekend with his girlfriend's family's house. As you all get ready to go outside of the walls of this institution into a world where you're going to flex your intellect and your talents and your abilities, it is unbelievably important for us to know who we rolling with. Let me be clear. Know who you're rolling with. Because the five people that you spend the most time with are going to define where you go and where you don't go. Who you confide in, who you talk to, who prays for you, who encourages you, who you call when you're in trouble, who is a role model with you and for you. Because I know that many of us come from places where people who want to be in our team, but they don't want to go where we go. There are even people that are in class with us that think they want what we want but don't have the grind that we have. There are people who want to be successful but people that don't have the discipline to work with other people like us. There are people who claim that they want to go to spaces that are righteous but they have no righteousness in them. And so the question for us as we begin this path into a new space is, do you really know the people that are rolling with you? Chris was in a difficult place because he claimed to be in love with somebody whose family he didn't know. And if you don't know the root of where somebody comes from, how can you know the principles and what they use to guide them where they're going? And so, my beloved brothers and sisters, what I would say to you, even as you begin this pragmatic journey into the marketplace of a global economy to be able to make money and make impact, is that the people who you roll with have as much to do with how much money you make and where the doors are open and who's going to work with you and who's going to take a chance on you as the skill set that you have. The second thing that I would say to you is, what I was confused by as I watched this film is the subtleties of us as individuals often being unclear about what our real value is. This was a movie that was ultimately about white people stealing black people for the purpose of using their bodies for their own benefit. It's an age-old story, I admit, with a new twist. But the challenge here is that many of us who are graduating actually forget that there is a system that is still set up to use you and your talents and your abilities for the purpose of that, and you not controlling the value of it. And so whether you're going into corporate America, or whether you're going into a legal profession, or whether you're creating a business, or whether you're simply a consumer, how many times do we as people of color consume without understanding the return on investment of what we consume, whether it's with our vote or with our dollars? So often, we go into the workplace or go into the